What is up, guys? Today I'll be giving y'all an update on my Dream CRF build. I haven't been posting about it lately, but today we're gonna get back to it and we're gonna get it started. It hasn't actually been running for a while, so let's get it out of the garage and run it. Right now, y'all probably wondering why the rear fender is missing. That's because I'm painting it right now. And while most of the faucets are missing because they're getting painted right now. This one is a test paint. It looks really nice, but it doesn't really match the paint, the original paint. Guys, we're gonna take the CRF for a spin just to warm it up. Right when I was about to pick up my camera, I noticed that there's an oil leak. Yeah, we gotta go get that fixed. So guys, before we even start doing anything like the simple maintenance, we're gonna have to take care of that oil leak. Start by taking off this bolt. Kind of wipe it off with the rag. Hopefully it doesn't mess up the paint. Oh, it does. We're gonna have to repaint that. These O-rings. And gonna stick one in there. Hopefully that stops the leak. If it doesn't, then I'll put, oh, that's hot. I'll put a metal spacer. So for removing the oil, you're gonna need an oil pan and you're gonna need your ratchet set. So for the oil drain bolt, it is 17 millimeter. Oh, that's hot. Just drop it in there. Yeah, I think that oil does need to be changed. Yeah. That oil is. So while waiting for all the oil to drain out, I'm gonna go check on the rear fender, see if it's done drying. This slides in to here. That's in. So let's install this. It's gonna go right there.
Oh, I'm gonna put the seat back on. And already, it looks better. Now the oil is done draining. You're gonna wanna clean it out. I'll search for this oil. I'll put a glove on it. The oil is gonna be hot. Oh man, that oil is hot. There's the bolt. I gotta clean that up. Wipe it with a rag. We're gonna put the drain bolt back in. And if y'all don't know where the drain bolt is, it's that hole. It's that hole right there. It's on the side where the Kickstarter is. It's that open hole right there. Now we're gonna put in the bolt. And I think it needs a new O-ring. That thing's pretty that thing's flat. So I'm gonna install a new O-ring on this. Clean that. So I'm gonna be using the Kirkland brand oil, 5W30. Use 5W30. And it doesn't matter what brand of oil you use. It's just as long as you change the oil often. So you're gonna want to pour it little by little, and then check your dipstick and refill it back. Let's check the oil level. Let's see. That's perfect. Okay, we're gonna let it run for a little bit, and then the oil level might go down. I don't know, but let's run it for a little bit and see. So now I started it. I'm gonna go take it for a ride again and see if the oil level changes. I can feel a difference. It shifts more smoother. So now that the oil is already done, we're gonna fix some stuff about it that's really bothering me. And one are the grips. Like, this grip is already ripping apart, and like, it gets stuck like a lot, and that's dangerous. That's very dangerous. And the other grip, very sticky and dirty. We're gonna replace that. And y'all are probably wondering, well, what grips am I going to replace it with? Well, that's why I sponsored Pro Taper. No, I'm playing. But we're going to try this Pro Taper grips on the CRF. So we got the Pro Taper grips here. Let's open this up. And as you can see, we got the Pro Taper grips right there. These are so nice. Let's see. We'll start with the throttle grip, and I think, yeah, it's this one. So there you go. This old grip, I think, has been on here ever since they bought the bike. Ever since we bought the bike in, I think it was like 2021 we bought the bike. 2020 maybe. But yeah, old grips, that's been there. That's the old one. And here's the new one. Yep, it just slides right out. I'm gonna get the Pro-Taper grip on. This is all it will go, but I'm gonna have to move this thing a little closer. It's just a Phillips screwdriver. There we go. Now I got the full set Pro-Taper grips on the bike.